Incident response is one of the most critical areas of information security, whether for incidents occurring in traditional platforms or cloud services. Despite all the best laid plans and all the effort invested in security systems, the possibility of an incident of some sort occurring can't be totally eliminated. The National Institute of Standards and Technology has published a standard for incident response frameworks called Special Publication 861. While incidents affecting cloud services can be mapped to this standard, some gaps exist due to the unique characteristics of the cloud. These gaps are covered in Domain 9 of the Cloud Security Association's guidance. Unfortunately, there are plenty of challenges when conducting incident response on cloud services. The commodity nature of cloud means that it can be difficult or impossible to get support from a cloud service provider in responding to an incident. SLAs typically don't cover incident response support, addressing only service fee refund claims. Resource pooling and elasticity may substantially complicate the technical activities of incident response and forensics. Maintaining stability and integrity of evidence when it exists on a shared and still operational infrastructure can be extremely challenging. Resource pooling also causes privacy concerns for co-tenants when collecting incident evidence such as logging, netflow data, physical machine images, and so on. This can be addressed through filtering out co-tenant information, but that filtering has to be done through a forensically acceptable process. In the cloud, data can cross jurisdictional boundaries without the cloud customer being aware. The legal implications of trans-jurisdictional investigations can affect what evidence can be recovered and the extent to which incident response can be effective. The NIST incident response model has four stages: preparation, detection and analysis, containment, and eradication and recovery. These stages flow from one to another, with some cycling back as the incident progresses, and with learnings being used to refine preparation plans. There are four significant considerations in preparing for cloud deployment incident response. When designing processes to implement the NIST incident response model, it's important to ensure that the location of cloud data is taken into account. This will have a significant bearing on how investigations and response processes work. The level of support available from the service provider in the event of an issue will be an important consideration for incident response. If the incident is a major cloud issue, then the service provider will be driving their own response, including some level of communication with customers. If it's a customer issue, then the service provider may not be involved at all. Threat intelligence is an important source of information prior to any incident due to malicious activity. It can help avoid incidents and can help more quickly identify the cause of incidents that do occur. It's important to establish ongoing access to a data feed of indicators of compromise. The Structured Threat Intelligence and Trusted Exchange Standards, STIX Taxi, are commonly used for this. The most important part of the preparation stage, however, is testing the incident response process and plan, and the initial exercises can be expected to flush out a number of issues with cloud services. Running cyber incident response exercises will help refine and mature the process. Timely detection has a fairly direct relationship to minimizing the impact of an incident. There are a number of issues that need to be considered when designing and operating the incident detection and analysis subsystem. Incident detection is based on log data, typically from the enterprise perimeter. In the case of cloud deployments, the source and availability of log data needs to be identified. The consistency of data also needs to be managed, particularly around timestamps. Both physical and virtual cloud components may change, and this can introduce data inconsistencies. It's also important to ensure the correct interpretation of cloud-sourced log data. Log retention and availability for analysis also needs to be considered, given the ability of advanced malware to exist for considerable periods of time before being detected. Forensics will be difficult. Customers will not be able to carry out traditional hands-on forensics on cloud infrastructure, and any requirement for forensics will be limited to the terms and conditions in service agreements. In June 2014, NIST released the draft NIST 8006, NIST Cloud Computing Forensic Science Challenges. This publication lists 65 problems covering lack of control over and reduced visibility into the infrastructure, difficulties in assessing and aggregating logs, hypervisor incompatibilities, the difficulty in establishing and validating the forensic soundness of what can be collected, encrypted data, and issues around preservation. Containment of attacks in cloud environments requires evolution of traditional containment methods. Containing an attack on a cloud target can be more effective and manageable when leveraging native capabilities provided by a cloud service provider. Network access controls between virtual networks or subnets within those virtual networks protect and contain east-west traffic within a cloud network infrastructure. Josh Payne's Deep Cloud Security Research Project has looked at various aspects of responding to malware in the cloud environment, and a visionary strategy could be to provide a containment mechanism using blockchain. In terms of eradication and recovery, refreshing virtual machines is a significant benefit of the virtualized environments used in clouds.